Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again. Just let me to move my chair because it's on my way. Good. And finally, today I'm gonna try for I don't know how many times to share with you some of ideas how you can make pocket inserts for your traveler notebooks, for your Midori style notebooks. I mean, this shape is long. It's not just this shape. I'm going to share with you how I am creating pockets, how I am creating those inserts where you've got so many pockets, so many hiding spaces. How I am thinking. It will be not proper tutorial. You know, my sharings are not tutorials, because I can't make it way like you have to do now this one, you have to do now this one, because I'm not thinking that way. I'm a very chaotic person, and those ideas are coming in second, and immediately after that I've got any other ideas, so I have to work at that second, because then I will lose it. So I'm going to try to share with you something, some ideas, hopefully. Wish me luck, because this video, it's not trying to take for the first time. I don't know how many times I tried before, and always I failed. Look, and it's so many right next to my legs. All those, I started, and then I finished video because it was just horrible. Even I was totally confused how I did it, what I said. So today I'm gonna just try to share with you how I am thinking. I'm going to show you types which I already made. If we are going on some holiday, we crafters, we hand makers of journals or of cards. Mostly, I believe many of us, we would like to create even on that holiday something. I'm thinking that way. I am preparing now for my holiday with my mommy. After 30 years, oh my god, after 30 years we will have holidays somewhere out of our house together, my mommy and me. And I am a little bit scared. Oh my god, I don't know what to expect. We are going to Greece, to island Rhodos. And I never been in Greece, so oh my god, I'm so excited and so scared at the same time. Hopefully it will be okay. So I'm preparing for my holiday, and I was thinking how I will take with me some kind of goodies, some kind of craft supplies. And maybe if I will get bored, which I hopefully will not, but if I will get bored, I can create something. So I prepared pockets, inserts for travel journals like this. This is my style of multi-folding Midori. I will show you pockets here inside. But here I made just, this is basic from file folder. I made this one. Here it's like basic spine. So you can open it here, and here you've got those flat back pearls. Underneath are doilies, and I'm gonna show you right now how you can make those pockets from your packaging. When you will get some packaging, do I have here some? Oh my god, I'm so scared I'm out of box. Wow, that will be awkward how I will show you. Let's get this back, maybe I can show it with this. Evie, you are not prepared. I'm gonna take off this, and I will show you how you can make beautiful pockets for your goodies from packaging. This is packaging bag with this sticky end. And what I did, I placed here, it's opening, okay? On this side is opening. So I placed double-sided tape on this flap. And with this flap, I glue it on my paper here. And then that rest, I fold it in the pocket, and I glue it all around with washi tape, like here. So here I've got pocket from that end. And when you because with that flap, with that opening flap, I glue it on my background. So now I can just unglue it, and I've got pocket here for my doilies. It's a very easy way how you can use those packaging for your pockets, and same way I did it here, I just glued that flap, that opening flap, double-sided tape, I glue it down like this, and here I made that pocket for those paper clips. So now I can open it this way, and inside are my flowers. Yeah, it's one sharing. Yay! Hopefully this way it goes, and hopefully it will be understandable. Here I use just this frame, I glue it on piece of acetate, and then I made like pockets for my stickers. It's very easy. And before I glued down this background, I made this my like page, and I glued it under that background, and then I glued that background over it, that this page. So you've got flap here, here you can store your tags, and here we've got pockets. Pocket is here for envelopes, for larger envelopes. Another pocket is here. You can just make layout with your paper and glue it just on three sides, and then you've got pocket, or make pocket like this on the top. Here I've got pocket for glossing bags, and another pocket is here. And here I'm storing my laces. I'm using this packaging, and this one, it was I think I destroyed something here. I purchased. I just now. They just now fly all over in my drawer. Those eyelets was packed in a small plastic case here. And when you open it, you've got this one, this small booklet. So I saved those because it's nice, you know, it's really beautiful. It's like small book. So I glued book pages on this side. This I left like it was, and I just cover it with, I'm gonna show you what I found. My new finding, it's this one. Tea dye varnish. Paper plus, I think it's paper plus tea dye varnish. It's like glue, it's like that top coat for your project. And it's making a nice, beautiful, like the exactly tea dyed effect. So I'm using it now. It's brilliant. It's really brilliant, and it's drying really fast, really fast. So if you are printing in black and white on white paper, then you just need to go over it with this one, and it will looks like it's dyed, coffee dyed or tea dyed. So like this, I'm storing my laces. So this is one pocket. This is same style, it's just not finished, and here I use those packages. It's, I think, from some stamps or from, what is it? And I just cut it half, and one I've got here on this side, another I've got here on that side. So it's another pocket for your goodies. And here, same way, I made pocket here. And I'm going to try to explain you how I made this. And you can make it from any kind of papers, file folders, cardstock. Because mostly, here I will show you, this is fully loaded journal, fully loaded, I promise. It's so heavy, I think it has over 1 kilo, definitely, maybe 2 kilos. It's a very heavy journal. It's that multi-opening, and I'm not finished yet. Just need few things. It has pockets here. I will share this journal with you later. But right now, I'm gonna show you a few more pockets. And hopefully, then I will explain you how I made it. This is made from one envelope. And here is pocket. On the top is pocket. Here is pocket. Here is pocket. Here is pocket. Here I used those acetates. I am now loving to use them. It's nice touch and it looks amazing. So here is pocket from those acetate. Here is just blank. It's pocket from the top and it's pocket here. It's one large envelope. That large one. I just folded that envelope in size of my travel journal. It was very easy. I cut this side, this end, I cut a little bit. Then I fold it in size of my travel journal. That flap I glued here down. And this opening, it's very easy to make if you've got some border punch. So you can make opening like this. As you can see here, I use this Martha Stewart punch. When I had scored those lines, I just place my punch in the middle of that, between those scoring lines, and I punch that. And then I took my knife, and from this side I cut that rest of that envelope till here, till that scoring line, and same on that other side from that punched piece, I just rip that envelope till that other scoring line. So now I've got entry from the top and that rest is still envelope. So this is really very easy how you can make your pocket inserts, because you've got here pocket and here pocket. And because this envelope was larger, was taller than it's my journal, I had to fold bottom of that envelope a little bit. So I'm using it like pockets here, that bottom of that envelope. I have to make it a little bit shorter. So it was this. How I fold it? Oh, I forgot. Oops. Like this. Nope. Like this. I have to finish background of those tags. But I've got another one. This is really very fully loaded journal. Here I've got another one. For this one, I used two very large pages. I used those pages. They are from a very old school atlas book with those maps. And those pages are on the end of that book. It's always their name. I think my music is too. Yeah, like this. On the end of those books, it's always that. I don't know how to say that. You know, you've got here a city, and then those navigating marks where you can find that city on which page and which those measurements. Oh my god! So I used two those large book pages to make this insert, and it's ending here, all this, and it has pocket here, 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 another pocket here, oops, I have to glue it again, now I unglue it, and here, and also it has pockets here on that background, but I used, as you can see, I used again those acetate because I love them. And here, this pocket I made separate and I glue it on the top. And do I have? And yes, if you've got some of your Midori or another travel journal, and you've got already full of your bandings with your inserts, still you can add there another insert if you will fit your elastic band on that insert. I've got it now. I just wanted to try if is it possible to add some, and this is very heavy insert. This one, it's very heavy, fully loaded. And I wanted to try if it will be fit together. So here I've got extra insert in my journal. Of course, you have to be very careful when you are taking off that extra insert, especially if you've got decorated pages. Make sure you will don't ruin your pages. See, I still got all embellishment and it's everything okay. Go there. Hey, come on, go there. Stay there. This is my writing board. You know, because those pages are decorated. I used that acetate, very heavy acetate. I used like a writing board. So, person who will carry this journal, if the person will wanna write down something on this page, here I've got this dimensional embellishment. So just take this one off, place it under your page and you can write easily. It's just a small tool for decorated journals. But I'm going to show you that insert. This I will show you later. Here I've got this insert. And when I choose my basic spine, like it's here, I just put those two eyelets and I put that elastic band through those eyelets. Here I decorate it a little bit, but I put those this elastic band and I glue it together and sew it together and fix it with this one to make sure that it will not... And now I can slide it over those inserts which I've got already inside. And it's holding properly. And this, it's made out of one file folder. And it's really fully loaded. It has pockets everywhere. Here is pocket. Here I used again that packaging style. So you can have something in those large pockets. And if somebody will don't know that it can be open, you can keep it there forever. And here is same style of pocket, it's just opening for this side. And here is pocket as well, and pocket is here as well. Here I used envelope. And I made multi pockets here. Like this. Here is pocket, here is another pocket. Here is like tuck spot, and here is pocket. And it's closing on magnet. And I've got pocket here, and again, I used acetate. I love to use those acetates. They look amazing. Look, it's brilliant. Touch it. It's just catching your eye, and it's just amazing. Oh, and I've got one more share. I just tried today. It's probably more for beginners. Where is it? I lost it. Oh, no, here. Hopefully, you will see that. I just wanted to try it if it works. It's probably for beginners who don't have yet all those tools and machines. And I mean that embossing machine, like it's Big Shot, Cutterburg, that Vagabond. If you don't have those machines and you would like to make something with that embossed effect, hopefully you will see that this page has like leaves, and it's because I'm gonna show you what I made. I just wanted to try it. Oh my god, did I lost it? Oh girls, if you will see that mess around me, you will laugh. And I lost it. Is this no, I didn't. While ago I made just small sharing that I am using this type of wallpapers for coffee dyeing, and they made amazing effect on my papers. Do I have it here? Unfortunately, I think I don't have that here. Okay. Here. Hopefully you will see that. Here, same effect, like it's here. It was made on my papers. And now, today, I wanted to try if I will take my printed image and I will glue it over it. And I will take this tool and I will vent over it properly if it will make some effect. And I tried on, because I printed on 110 grammage papers, printed papers. They are a little bit heavier and it didn't make anything. So I had to take those very cheap, I think it's 80 grammage, those very cheap light papers. And I printed again some images. And then I glue it, and with those very light papers, it makes this beautiful effect. If you nicely, you know, like push it through to that wallpaper, it will make soft but very nice embossed effect. And when you are going over it, it's a really very beautiful touch. So this is my sharing what I found today. I think someone already did it, but I just found it today, so I'm sharing it. So I'm going to show you how I'm making those pockets, or how I am thinking. I'm gonna take like my measurement. This one, I've got prepared few pages for next, this kind of Midori style. And this is basic for all those Midori. It has 11 centimeters here and 21 centimeters here. But it doesn't matter how large or how small journal you wanna make. I will show you how I am thinking when I am making some book pages. Book pages. See? Some pockets. I just got today those beautiful, what is it, Rubons in this large envelope. And it was so funny packed. Here was another envelope. And it was like folded, and I was thinking, wow, look at that. It's pocket here, pocket here, and pocket here. So I'm going to show you. It was just what took my breath away, how that person who sent me those ribbons, how that person amazingly was thinking to put so many envelopes together, and it was great. It was just great. So if I will take this envelope, like my, come on, my English, material, God. And this is like my measurement. Normally I'm not using it, but for you guys, if I will wanna use it, I will place it, and it's a little bit bigger, okay. I don't wanna have anything to peek out, so I'm not gonna use this envelope like this. Probably I will use it like this, and I will make some folding. So, and because I don't have large scoring board, I'm planning to purchase that, but always I found something else. So I'm purchasing something else, and I didn't get there yet. I will. So, because I don't have large scoring board, mostly I'm folding those pockets by my eye, using just this tool for make nice and that beautiful folding. Or if I am not sure, I'm using my ruler. I've got very long metal ruler, which is brilliant. But I will show you how I am making normally. So if I will use this envelope for my travel journal, I will make multi-folding pocket. I will cut it here, because I will want to have entry from both sides. Here I can use just my scissors. So I've got like tunnel now. And I will want to have this like pockets like this one. I've got small scoring board. I can use that. If I remember that right, 11 centimeters, it's 4 inches and something. I think 3/8. Yes, 4 inches and 3/8. So I'm gonna score it. 4 inches and 3/8. I've got mark here. This will be like my first page. Fold it. Make it nice, crisp. And now I will thinking, do I wanna have this like open and here some kind of pocket and open here, or how I will want to use this? So probably I will want to have something like booklet, and I will want to have this like my flop over it. So I'm not going to use any scoring board. I'm just going to fold it this way, and then will comes together my my decorating. So here I will place some basic paper, and before I will glue it down, I will use some closing, fix it on that basic paper, and then I will glue it down. I will glue it down, yes, to make closure here, or I will use some, maybe some ribbon, hopefully, I will. Sorry. Which means I will have pocket here. I can make... Oops. It will be so less pockets. So I will use something more for creating many pockets with this small envelope. Probably I will think in this way that I will glue it here. Yes, definitely. I know myself, I will glue this envelope on my basic. And I will glue it. I will make entry. I'm gonna show you how I made that before. Those Martha Stewart punches have here on that top edge, they've got here some marks. I think it's 1/4 inch. Maybe. So place your envelope, those scoring lines, place them even on both sides, which will make your punch right in middle. You got this one, still it's closed, those edges, okay? Still it has closed those edges together. Now I'm gonna take the knife, and it's like when you're opening letters, nice, carefully, just cut it, yep, come here, just cut it till that scoring line, don't go too far. Come on, that's my tool. If you can see my head, I'm so sorry for that. Yeah. And then I will glue it on my page. I can do it now, because that page is nice. Yeah. I'm gonna glue it now. First I will cover my address, because it will be awkward. If someone who will receive that will see my address, that will be no good at all. Like this. For me. And I'm going to make it nice. Because I've got here those round edges, I will try to use my punch, which I've got from my lovely friend Jane. Thank you so much, Jane. Thank you for that punch. It's brilliant. I'm using it now more than mine because it's really amazing. Yes. Will I make it here? Show me. I can leave it peek out a little bit. Yes, I can. Yes, I can. I'm going to make here. I'm going to make here beautiful edges. And then I will glue it down. I will glue it from those sides, and it will make pocket, double pocket here. It will be pocket here and behind. Then it will have pocket here, here, and of course I will make some pocket here. So this way I'm thinking with those small envelopes. Put it, put it. If we will take some simple divider, I think you call it this divider, it's not file folder, it's simple divider. Mostly that size, A4 size, it's size of this side, it's how higher it's your travel journal, mostly, I believe so. I'm gonna take my ruler, I'm gonna check it out, yes, 21 centimeters. A4 size, it's brilliant for those travel journals, because this, it's exactly what Midori notebooks have, like, what is it, height. So, I will take this. And probably I will score it first a little bit on this my small scoring board. If you've got large scoring board, use it because it's a brilliant tool. I have to purchase that because it's really much more easy than with ruler. So I'm gonna score it here. And I'm gonna take this like my basic, oops, like my basic page. Will be like my first page, and I will probably want to have here a little bit bigger gap, because I will wanna make this like my insert, extra insert. So I will score there 4 3/8, so next scoring line I will have 4 1, 2, 3, 4, 5/8. And I think in this gap my eyelets will fit. And now I need to fold it in that next scoring line. This give me my spine. And now I need to score this. Unfortunately, I don't have that black space, so I'm gonna flip it over. First, I need to make mark, because I don't have, you know, that scoring, large scoring board. So 11 centimeters, it's one side, and I want to have both sides same deepness. So I'm going from, here is first scoring line, here is second scoring line, this is my spine. So from here, I'm gonna measure 11 centimeters. It's somewhere here. It's here, so somewhere here, I will make another. Here, good. I need to put in that large scoring board. And I will make it like this. Now I'm gonna build up my pages. This is basic for my pocket pages. If I will be lazy, I will take some envelopes and I will glue envelopes, because they are already prepared and it's easy to use them, and you already have that basic with pocket, and you can build up some more pockets over it. Hey, yeah, here I found another one. See? I'm telling you, I went crazy. I went crazy. Here. I couldn't find them, sorry. I went crazy with that showing you what you can do, and then I was totally lost. So here, because it's very cheap folder. At the first, I will somehow decorate those edges, because it's pink and I don't like pink. So I will probably use black color, black marker, or black, or I can try, because this one it's a very rich color. Maybe this will work. Try. Oh, that will work. I'm gonna very fast This is Dawcraft Premium Pigment Ink Pad, and this color, it's Cocoa Brown, and I really like this color because it's rich, and you can cover with this color nearly any other colors, and it will make a nice brown color. I will need to tidy up my table. Look at that. Oops. Very fast way. And I will use probably some decorative paper. I should be prepared for this one. And here. This. It's a really very rich one. This is really brilliant ink because it's so cool. Like this. Also those around my spine. And because this is very light divider, I need to make that spine strong enough to hold my pockets and everything what will be in my pockets. And I'm using for many weeks now, I'm using that medical tape, and I couldn't choose better because it's holding properly. You can even color that medical tape. I'm gonna show you right now. Sorry for my hands, they are already dirty. This medical fabric tape. Gonna make my spine stronger. I'm gonna start here. We'll go all over, hopefully on the right. You know that medical tape, it's strong enough to hold your papers, and you can color it and still you can bend your paper and it will make any problem with your pages. It will not destroy your construction. Yeah. Okay. Just cut it out. I'm gonna show you. One side of my spine. I'm going to show you how you can easily color. Oops. This great tool. Here I should make it a little bit deeper. I will place probably one more on this edge, but look how dirty it is now. A little bit tidy up my table because I don't like this mess. Yeah, it's really good ink. It's really very good ink. It's holding properly. Okay. And now I will start to place my decorative paper. And when I will put that decorative paper, I will place there probably one envelope here. No, this is too long envelope. Alright, can you use it here? It will be another decorative effect, I think. Show me. Yeah, I can do it this way. If I will place this envelope on this edge, I will round all corners because I like more those round corners. I don't know why, but I like them a little bit more than those curvy corners. Come on, go there. Good boy. Okay. And this way I tried to show you before. And I always screw up. So hopefully now I will don't. And I try to share with you so many great channels you can go for inspiration, for good mood, for amazing feeling and amazing ideas. And I think that's why I screw up, because I more concentrate. I've been more concentrating on sharing those informations with you. Then, yes, I will glue this on my envelope here. I'm gonna use this glue. I will glue this here on this side. On my envelope. Let it dry. So you will have opening here. Here you already have pocket here. And if you will glue it down, one more envelope here. Make decorative view here. Do I have some nice paper all around? Of course I have. I've got loads of papers. I've got here this beautiful paper. My measurement. Okay, guys. My measurement. Right? I'm gonna cut out this. I'm gonna show you how I am taking my measurement. I've got here this gorgeous paper. If you wanna know which kind of paper this is, it's amazing collection from Dreams Etc. I found it on, not on Etsy shop, I found it on her blog, that other shop. And it's called Documented, and I love that paper because it's brilliant. So this is my measurement, okay? I'm placing my paper how I want it. If I wanna have some small edge, I'm placing it a little bit here, and then I'm making mark with my pen, if I will find any, where I have to cut it out, but here I don't want to have too much. It will be good like here, and here I will make mark. It's for widest or deepest, and then I'm placing from the top, and where on the bottom I should cut it out, it's here, okay? Then I'm gonna show you which tool I purchased not a while ago, but recently I purchased guillotine. This guillotine I purchased because my paper trimmer from Fiskars just broke down, that this arm just breaked in middle. So I had to purchase some another guillotine. This guillotine, this paper cutter, it's brilliant for heavy cardstock, but it's too bad for papers. Because it has no too long arm, this one. So first I need to cut it here. here like this, somehow like this, and here I've got another mark, and it's like this. So this is my measurement. And I will make those beautiful. Sorry for my head. I am so sorry for my head. You will see much more of my head than of that project, I'm guessing. Hey, come here. Don't stop there. Come here. Right, a little bit this, and I will glue it down right here. Yes, exactly like this. Where is it? Sorry for my head to be there again. I'm so sorry, guys. I'm so sorry. I'm always in your view. And now I will probably glue down another envelope because it will give me much more pockets. It will be pocket here. It will be pocket here. And if I will be very exciting, I will make it different way, probably, somehow. I can make it like a booklet. You know, I'm playing, and I'm thinking, what is more interesting? I'm horrible with this. But it's so funny to play with that paper. I can make it like this, and open this way. And if I will glue this flap just on those three sides, it will make pocket from here as well. So this way, I'm thinking, I'm kind of building those envelopes and even papers, even piece of papers, I'm trying to build and turn around and think how I can open it, if it will be hold like this in my journal. Will be possible to fix it, everything inside. Yes, of course, it's always possible. If you've got the right measurement, it's always possible to fix it inside, fit it inside. So this way, I was thinking with that simple divider. And now I will try to explain you. I can't show you. I am so very sorry. As you can see, my tools are not good enough to show you exactly, step by step, what I made. But I will try to explain you. What I made with those file folders, that I end up with this. It was really easy, it's not too hard. I've got only basic file folders, they look like this. It's just two pages. That's it, it's just two pages. Which you can open, that doesn't have those fancy folders. I tried to make them here, but I made that wrong. I made one on the bottom and another one here, which is not. And then I tried to make another one and I lost it. I think I use it here. No. Okay, I will try to explain you what I made. In those three pages folders, I used this way. I start from one side and I measured 11 centimeters. In inches, that measurement, it's side, this deepness, it's 4 and 33 inch, and that higher of that travel journal is 8 and 25 inch in inches. But I don't know too much to work in inches. I never used before inches till I found this amazing craft family and those amazing projects. So I'm working always in inches, mostly in inches. So you will start from one way and you will score your folder like it is, place it on your scoring board and score 11 centimeters or those 4 and 33 inch. Then I scored my gap here, that basic spine. Here I used half centimeter. Just let me see, 1 centimeter. I made gap 1 centimeter, which is half of inch, nearly half of inch, a little bit less than half of inch. I scored another scoring line for my spine. Then I scored again 11 centimeters for this page. They are same, both. And then that rest, it's this one because it was longer. It should be here as well, but I wanted to create this decorative edge. So when I scored, it was 11 centimeters, that gap. Or if I will take it, you know, I score it like this, because it's exactly. If I will place it on my scoring board, I will place it with that folded line in that corner. And I will score it like this. First will be that first side. It will be 11 centimeters or those 4 33 inch. Then gap. I've got 1 centimeter gap or half an inch. Another scoring scoring line. Then score again 4 and 33 inch or those 11 centimeters. And here I didn't make any gap. I just scored this one. And here you can see, this is that my flap. It was end of my folder. Then when I've got those scoring lines, I open it. This I left how it was. And here, till that folding line, I cut out this piece between those pockets, and I cut out cut this line between those two pockets, and that's it. And then I just fold it back and I glue it and I fold it together. It's very easy way from file folders if you are using that file folder this way. Here I open it, it's same style, and as you can see, it gave me four beautiful four pages. And it's because I used that file folder open, and I went same way. I start on one side. I always starting on this side because I'm using for that measurement, I'm using my ruler to make those marks. And I start on this way. You can start on this way if you are using your scoring board. And again, I made scoring lines. If you will make scoring lines, and this was my basic, it was 11 centimeters. Then I made small gap. Then you make gap bigger as you want. Then again, 11 centimeters. Smaller gap, because I'm planning to roll it together. So that first gap, if you want to roll it together, that first gap have to be biggest than those others. Always that next gap make a little bit smaller, and next gap made a little bit smaller than this one, because then you can roll it together really properly without any struggling. If you want to have folding just this way, you can make it those same size, and this probably bigger because it will be probably your basic spine. So when I scored all those lines with those gaps, then I scored this line. It's 21 centimeters from here to here, 21 centimeters skirt or those 8 and 25 inch. And then I just fussy cut out those lines, those pieces, and it makes my pockets. And if I will decorate it, I will decorate it same way, that some of those pockets will be only pocket and some nice embellishment like here. Like it's here, this is just pocket and just embellishment. And some of those pockets will be pocket here. And on that I will build up another pocket using layouts from paper. This is pocket where I am storing those paper clips. Oh, this I can share with you as well. I found myself that mostly when I opening some packaging and I'm leaving those goodies in that bag, they are soon or later just falling out from my bag, because those packaging, you know, when you've got that small piece of cardstock on the top, put together with that stapler, and you take it off that cardstock and you've got only that bag. Those goodies inside are mostly falling out of that. So I took book page and I made piece a little bit deeper than it's my back of my goodies. I glued those goodies, that back, on that piece of cut, piece of book page. And then I fold, I've got piece of cardstock, piece of book page a little bit longer, and I glue it nearly in the middle. I fold this end and I glue it over it till I think half of that back. Then I fold this side, including piece of that back, which give me the, which make me sure that my goodies will not fall down because they are folding inside. And here I made just belly band and I'm sliding this one behind, so it's nice packaging. It's travel packaging. Hopefully it's understandable. Not sure. Do I have something that I can here? I'm gonna try. Fold it. Hold it. See? It's folding again. I'm gonna make it like this. Okay. I will make it really fast. I took a piece of book page. Just bear with me. I'm gonna bring some small bag with goodies. Bear with me. Gonna show you on this one. As you can see here, it's put together with those staplers. What is it? Stapler, I think. Once you open it, the package, if you don't have any some storage box, and you will just leave it on your table, it will start to falling down. If you will touch that, packaging, that bag. So I was thinking how I can make it to stay inside. So I took book page, I glued that, make it a little bit stronger. And I think this is brilliant for traveling. Once you opening your goodies, you don't have to be scared and you don't have to use so many paper clips. You can use paper clips, but they can fall down as well. So I made that book page a little bit stronger. But probably you don't have to. but I made it. Then I put on one side of that bag, I put double-sided tape on all that surface. I put double-sided tape. How many tapes I've got here? Double-sided tape. I glued my bag on my book page. Kinda here. And then I was thinking I'm gonna fold this here, but I don't wanna have cover all that back, so I'm gonna make a gap that ends probably here. So I cut it out. And of course I used that round corner to make it a little bit nice. Yeah, like this. Then here is ending of my back. Here is end of my back. This is way I will put those small goodies inside. So I was thinking I need to fold that back a little bit to make sure that those goodies will not fall out. So I fold it like here, and then I cut that end of that book page, but I left a little bit longer. And I was thinking middle, it's somewhere here. Somewhere here is middle. So I will leave this like my flap. And I can cut till here, till this line. Probably. So I cut piece of from that book page. It should be long enough, because if you will put here that belly band, this should be slide inside. So not too long, but not too short. This. This, I made those corners like the round, but now I'm going to show you. Then I use that piece what I cut out, I use it like my belly band, make it a little bit smaller. I just put that piece here. Oops, show me. Slide it. Yeah, it will fit. Oops, I can use them right now just for demonstration. Fit it in. You can glue it, of course, you can glue it and fix it with those brads. Hey, come on. No? Come on. Oh my, I can't find, sorry, I'm a little bit slow. Now put your goodies back to your bag. All of them, fit them inside. Slide this, and if you will fold it over, you've got nice travel packaging of your goodies, and you can put them to your pockets like here, so you can make sure that even if you will smash it somewhere, because that bag inside, it's fold, that end of that bag, it's fold, those goodies will not fall down. So this is like travel packaging for your goodies. But what else I can show you? Now I am lost myself what I wanted to show you. So let me to make a little bit order here on my table because it drives me crazy. I got that mess everywhere. Okay. Hopefully this wasn't too much confusing. Hopefully. If it was confusing, I'm so sorry, just let me know that then I will try to make it better. But I'm telling you, I tried. I confused myself. And I'm just going to show you here, I tried to make those flaps. So when I took measurement, I draw my flap here on this side, and then I took measurement from here. If you've got file folders with those beautiful fancy edges, take measurement of your side from here. If you wanna have peek out this beautiful fancy, what is it, tab out of your, like this one, if you will want to this to be peek out from here. If you wanna have that flap like inside of your, come on, like to be height, same deepness like basic of that page, start to make measurement from here. Not from here, but from here. Those 11 centimeters or those 4 and 33. So here I try to do it myself. I draw it. Because I like those fancy tabs on the side. So if I will fold this, it will look like this one. You know, I will have beautiful tab here. Here I have to make a corner. And beautiful tab here. I like those because it looks different. It makes some kind of interest on your page. What else I can show you? We've got those file folders. Hopefully my battery didn't die yet. No, not yet. And hopefully, oh my god, did you see something? Or I was out of view. And I can show you how I made it from 12 by 12. I tried to from 12 by 12. I will explain you. I made it same way. Just place your 12 by 12 paper on your scoring board if you've got it. If you don't have scoring board, use your ruler. Make marks. 11 centimeters, then gap, again 11 centimeters, smaller gap. If you have, if you wanna have dimensional pockets, like pockets where you can fit a lot of inside, so make that gap between. If you don't need them to be dimensional, you can just make small gap here and then here, just one scoring line, and it will be okay. You know, it will be folded really good. And it's very easy when you will score those lines. Like 4 and 3 eighths, then gap, 4 and 3 eighths, and scoring line. Then flip that paper this way. Oh, no, sorry. You've got those scoring lines because I don't know this measurement, you know. Then flip your paper this way. Here you've got corner of that scoring board, you know. 1, 2, 3, 4, you know. So you've got those scoring lines. Then flip your paper this way. And score line here is 8 and 25 inches. Inch, not inches. 8 and 25 inch. If you want to have just normal pockets, flat pockets. If you want to have a little bit dimensional pockets, make a small gap here on the bottom. I've got 2 millimeters, which is 1/8 inch. So first will be 8 and 25 inch scoring line. Then will be, I don't know. God, how many will be there? how many will be there? 8 and 25, it's probably... See? I don't know that inches. You know, make some gap. And then, cut out those pieces. Including here, including that gap. You need, here you need just your pages, not that gap. If you will fold it and you will leave that bottom, like it's like floor of your pocket. This one, it's like floor of your pocket, this. If you will leave it here, it will like peek out to the air, it will be not nice. So cut it out just under your pages and it will give you your pocket. Oh my god, I wanted to share with you a lot of more, but I think that now I am lost myself. What else I can share with you? Oh yeah, when you're creating something, some insert, pocket insert for your journals from envelopes. Thank god. But this, everybody knows this one. God. Here I made something, even myself, I don't know what I made. Oh, yay. Yes, I'm going to show you this one. One large envelope. And one, this envelope, I already showed you, did I? I forgot what I showed you. Oh, yeah, I showed you on that, what is it? What is this one? Divider, yeah. Same way you can do it on envelope, on large envelope. This I showed you, how you can create that middle pocket, middle top load pocket, and those side pockets. Here is one. And here is another one. And because I'm using this envelope, so here I've got another one, and here I've got another one. And I'm going to show you, here you can see how I have to fold. This is normal size of envelope. But because that envelope is higher than its measurement of my kind of Midori measurement. Here you can see. This is Midori size. 11 by 21. So that envelope is higher. So if I want to have that insert just good enough, I had to fold that envelope. So it will make pockets here. When I will glue it down, it will make pockets here. And here will be pocket. So it will be like this. And that envelope, that large envelope, I glued again just on those three sides. So it will be pocket here, and pocket here, and pocket here. And here, something. I think I'm gonna finish for today. I will try to think a little bit more for next time. Oh my god. I hope I didn't confuse you so much. I really hope maybe you found something interesting. There is so many amazing video tutorials how you can make those pocket inserts. So please go to check it out because there is really so many. I'm sorry if I confused you. I'm thinking if something more. Probably not. Probably not. Hopefully you found some inspiration. Oh, yeah. Here I've got just from large. This is A5 size of envelope. And I just scored those sides. To make them even. I think it's in size. Yes, it's inside of that travel journal. And now I will cut this. I will cut this down. It's what I'm planning to do with this one. I use decorative corner scissors. Those are from Fiskar. This decorative corner scissors. And I'm planning to make this one, this way, like that gatefold multi-pocket. when I will glue it down on my page, I will glue it down this way. It will be pocket behind, it will be pocket here. Here I will probably sew papers, and it will be pocket here with those flaps. Or I will glue it down this one, and I will make probably pockets from those sides. That will be much more easier. I will glue it down those flaps, and I will make pockets from here. It will be like this. I think it's all what I can share today. Hopefully, oh my god, I hope I didn't confuse you so much. Hopefully you found some inspiration. There is really loads of interesting and amazing tutorials on YouTube where you can find inspiration, how you can make pocket inserts for your travel journals or for any journals. So go to check it out. If you found some inspiration, I'm more than happy. If I confused you, I'm so sorry. I hope I'm not. Thank you so much for watching. Oh my god, I forgot. I wanted to share with you those informations. Someone asked me, then not just someone, it was few questions I've got. I have to share it with you. So now it's coming chatting. And if you don't mind, I'm going just through to this journal. You can have a look what I'm creating right now, and I will chatting with you. I had few questions. First question, when I am shopping, some lady from UK, she asked me where I am shopping, that she's starting to to making journals, and she doesn't know where to go shopping. Mostly I'm shopping on eBay for metal embellishments, and I'm purchasing them from China mostly, because I'm purchasing that bigger packing, not just 10 pieces but mostly 50 pieces. I'm kind of harder. I have more. So for metal pieces, I'm going on eBay and I'm finding those filigrees. For laces, it depends. I've got loads of laces from my lovely neighbor Penny. I've got loads of laces from my mommy. And if I need to purchase some lace, I'm coming again mostly on eBay. I don't know, that eBay, it's just really quick. So I'm mostly purchasing those things on eBay. Then I've got few shops, online shops for craft goodies, and I will share links down below in that description box below, those shops I found. Of course, it's The Works. Online The Works, they've got much more to offer than normal The Works. Like, I mean that brick, or how you call it them, those brick shops, those proper shops. Those online shops, they've got much more to offer. So I'm purchasing a lot of things from The Works online. Where I'm going there? I'm not sure. I will share links for those shops I'm visiting online down below in that description box. Another sharing, it's about inspirations, where I'm taking inspiration. Of course, here on YouTube, definitely here on YouTube, here is so many amazing, brilliant crafters, artists. And I'm coming there not just for inspiration about junk journals or about mixed media or about something what I need or about design. There is a lot of amazing, wonderful channels. I'm coming for nice feeling. One of my favorite is Amity Bloom, Nazi. That girl is amazing. She's so positive. And when you are visiting her channel, you are leaving with that positive feeling, with that happy feeling. So she's one I'm visiting for both, for amazingly done journals, beautiful journals, gorgeous journals. She's making those fabric/paper journals, that mix of journals. Then it's my lovely friend, I love her because she's got huge talent. I love her journals. And I love her sense of humor. She's so amazing. My lovely friend Rhonda, her channel, it's a little Rhonda Lee. And I really love to watch her channel because I'm always feeling like I am in a jazz club and with that great positive mood. And I feel so good to watch her, to listen to her. So Rhonda, it's definitely someone who you wanna see. And her journals are amazing. Her vintage journal. And her, oh my god, her steampunk, I think it was called steampunk grungy or grungy steampunk journal or something like this. And not sure how long time ago, maybe half an year time ago, she made it. And it's brilliant. And also kitchen book. Oh my god, for recipes. That's amazing book. So go to check out her. For amazing ideas, I think many of you know that lady. Unfortunately, she didn't post any new post for more than 1 year. I mean, Annie from Xanerovan. She is one of a kind. Really, she's one of a kind. She is totally, oh my god, totally unbelievably talented lady. So she is my huge inspiration. For journals, of course, Michelle Mooney. I'm visiting her channel because of her. I found this amazing craft family. I found this crafting. I never imagined before I found Michelle channel that something like those journals exist or something like those amazing photo albums exist. I always was crafting something, but it was just basic. It was just that kids creating. It was just basic painting. I never thought I will saw so many amazing mixed media projects. You know, so this is lady I'm visiting. In journals, oh my god, girls, you are all amazingly talented. It's thousands of Jung journals channels I'm visiting. And now, right now, I don't know where to start. I've got ladies like it's Creative Cafe Girl, like Patty. I love Patty because she's using so many great dyes and she's explaining everything. She's NW Lady 1949. I love her channel, watching her her creations because she explains everything. You know, there is so many, I can't tell you, oh my god, I can't tell you because it's so many and right now it's going through to my head, you all. So I will try to think in nice and peaceful time, right, with my coffee in my hand and with cigarette in another hand. And I will calm down because right now I'm a little bit nervous that I will don't say someone and it will just upset you and make you sad. No, guys, you all are amazing. I promise. I love your work. You all are special. I'm learning from you, so you have to be special if I am able to do something. So I will put links for those shops down below. For beginners, I will put a link for Xanerovan channel down below and you will see something unbelievable. Really, I hope those other ladies will forgive me that she will be only one I will put down below because I'm still totally amazed of her work. She's amazing. So, I think hopefully nothing else. And of course my Elena. Oh my god, my Tundra, hi Tundra, Elena, hi Elena, sweetie, I have to write you a message, oh my god, I'm horrible, oh, who else, oh my god, girls, it's a lot of you, Despina, hi Despina, hopefully we will see soon. This is all my sharing for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you was so brave to watch me till now, thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you found something interesting. Thank you so much for your amazing comments, messages, for your support, for everything what you're making for me. You know, it's only you and then my sons who are not thinking that what I'm doing here, it's wasting of time. Because the rest of my family is thinking that it's wasting of time. They know that it's nice, but they think I should find some another job and make some money. They think that this is just playing kids. So, because of you, I'm always feeling so good that I'm making something, you know. And because of my son, because they support me really good. They always say, Mom, just continue. Don't think that you will give up. Just continue. You like it and you are peaceful and calm when you're creating. Just continue. So they are so good. So thank you so much for all your support. For all your support. You are my stars. This is all my sharing for today. I'm saying that probably so many times. Thank you so much for watching. Take care about yourself. And see you next time. Bye.